Okay. So the topic that I have chosen to talk today is actual, contextual, and again, virtual empowerment of women. Many a times, we always think that empowerment is some sort of the power that is given to women to decide about various aspects of their life. It could be in terms of their life, or day-to-day activities, or could be some sort of decisions on personal aspects which affect them individually, family, or could be in terms of their body, or could be in terms of their lifestyle or food, whatever it might be, or even economic positions or the disposition that they have in terms of resources and various other issues. But what we need to understand right now is much of the knowledge which is available in our own Indian context needs to be unearthed. Point number one. Point number two, we need to understand that new knowledge in the name of empowerment, which is coming from the West, is one way it is theoretically good, but at the same time, it looks very acontextual. We need to contextualize many things. We need to contextualize Indian scenario and various other aspects. So, while talking about this particular aspect, are men and women same? The first question that we need to understand in terms of how do we differentiate the empowerment of women and again men in a different context altogether. I'm bringing women as a center point here to discuss and debate how men are different and how women are different in terms of the constitution, in terms of the whole body structure, the very functioning pattern and also the performance of it. These are all some sort of biological in nature. They're all fixed and again, nothing much could be done. Though science is also questioning those particular structures of it and also attempting to make some sort of changes in all those aspects. But these stereotypes needs to be understood from a different perspective altogether, that why we are not trying to equate them or why we are not trying to have some sort of level playing ground for women and also men kind of a thing. And various other issues have been raised at various levels. But my question would not be to understand the level playing aspect. In fact, I would rather put that women are much more powerful than men in terms of structure and the constitution and also the functioning pattern, various other things. The kind of multitasking that women do is much more multiples in terms of what men have been doing or could have done. But giving those aspects aside, now have we really try to understand how empowerment has taken place in the recent past, or empowerment has taken place in the real past in the sense. So I'm trying to see things in a different argument altogether, trying to see in terms of actual, that is in terms of much more theoretical kind of an explanation for all those kind of issues. And then the second aspect that we need to understand is basically contextual, that is the present scenario, I would like to put it as, because every day the things are changing, situations are changing, challenges are changing. So we need to understand from the present perspective. At the same time, we need to see it from the real world, that is the virtual world, which is beyond our imagination or beyond our expectations or beyond your thoughts. So as a result, obviously, the challenge in the virtual world is much more different. So virtual world also further can be divided into in terms of the digital world also, which I'll be addressing at a later stage. Now the whole issue is basically trying to understand how the past, present and future needs to be understood in the context of empowerment. A present scenario, as much of the webinars are being debating about, is the COVID-19. These events come and go. Earthquakes come and go. Calamities come and go. Global challenges, pandemics, epidemics, and various kind of things, challenges, these, they come and go. But in the whole structure of these kind of dimensions of human existence, if you try to understand the family as a structure, now where exactly is the family located and who is affected most? Who is the pillar of this particular dimension of understanding the disturbed period? Is it the men or is it the women as the children or older people? Now, who are the most affected people? If we try to understand those scenarios from a different angle, then we have different challenges. There are lots of sociological constructions which gives a different dimension altogether, which challenges our understanding, which challenges our perspective altogether. So there are sociological constructions in terms of how men have to behave, how men have to behave or women have to behave, a girl child has to behave, a boy. In adulthood, how one has to behave and various other dimensions are again explained. In the youth, in the middle age, in the old age. These are all clip arts I have not tried to use acontextually. I am trying to use in terms of how every stage of life, both boy and a girl, man and a woman, everybody is trying to make some sort of dimensions of all those issues. Now, every society has defined in terms of the kind of dress one has to wear, the kind of language that one has to speak, the kind of work one has to perform, and the role that is to be played. Everything is being defined in those dimensions. So if you try to see, this is not common across region. Region to region, it varies. From place to place, it varies. From different provinces, it varies. From country to country, it varies. But by and large, there is some sort of a stereotype perceptions of what men have to do and what women have to do, these kind of issues. So if you try to understand these stereotype expectations, like what men expect and what women expect, there are lots of books which define the behaviors of men and women. Men are from Mars, women are from Venus. So there are stereotyped notions. Women are always emotional, men are more pragmatic. Now these kind of stereotype notions need to go beyond our understandings. Nevertheless, sociological constructions are basically in terms of how society expects you to behave. But at the same time, do we understand that in the process of actual, in the real world of expectations, in the race of trying to equate men with women, the empowerment is giving more and more responsibility to women by saying that you need to equate with boys, you need to equate with men, you need to equate with male. What has really basically happened is basically women already have been doing multitasking, but there are challenges being added to it. I wanted to prepare a slide on that, but I wanted you people to imagine things so that your expectations and your logical understandings would differ from my PPT. PPT will fix you rather than the words and imaginations will throw open lots of imaginations. Biological expectations of women are by and large fixed in terms of the menstrual cycles or maybe the childbearing capacity, the lactation, and various other aspects which are fixed and nothing could be done. But then that's a great gift that the God has given to women, which men cannot by any chance take up that role. Added to that, now the question comes in terms of there were demarcations of responsibilities and roles in the society that you perform these activities and you perform these activities. There was some sort of an understanding in different societies. Different societies had different roles to perform at various levels. Now, but in the name of equating, I have already said that women are far ahead than men. But again, in the name of equating, women are being forced to do what men are doing. So when what men are doing, it could be some sort of social rules, the role of a father. I'll explain that the concept with the role of a father, where a single parent is there, where the husband is not living with the wife. And the child is being taken care by the wife. So the role of a father, the fatherly figure responsibility is completely taken care of. Family roles, the roles that men were supposed to be doing, those responsibilities are being pushed into. As a woman, why can't you do this? Why can't you drive a vehicle? Why can't you go to the market and fetch vegetables or go to grocery shop and get groceries? So slowly there is some sort of an expectation that what men can do, let women start doing it. So it is in a way, at initial stage looks like that I have conquered the roles of men. But look at it from the other side. Have the men started doing the roles of the women, in some cases where there are proper understanding, that's fine, well and good, it's happening. But in many cases, many things are not happening. It is being dumped onto the women. So I'm just giving you so that you can start imagining things, and again, you will come out with your own examples. Social roles are being attached. New family roles are being attached. At the same time, you need to get educated, and again, you need to get jobs and then start running to the job in the morning itself. Cooking has not stopped in the family. Women, whether you are a working woman or non-working woman, whether you're a housewife or working outside, irrespective of your income group, irrespective of your class, irrespective of your position, the role of women in the kitchen has not changed much. Technology might have definitely improved in terms of moving from the wood to gas, or from sort of electronic furnaces or various other microwave and various other issues. But still, the role of cooking has not changed much in any society for that matter, all over the world. So has it reduced the responsibility of women? So this is the real challenge that we need to understand, that the empowerment is happening in the name of giving equation or maybe equating things. People are being dumped with more responsibilities that you can do it, please do it. So you can just start showing that you are nowhere less than any boy or men or any of those issues. So the moment you get into professions after getting educated, you need to get into jobs, and job demands lots of responsibilities. Being punctual, doesn't the job people do not expect you to, or does not give you any leverage or any of sort of some sort of provisions of various other relaxations. The moment you have a baby or you have cooked and you have various other personal problems, doesn't matter. You need to be in the office by 9 o'clock, means you need to be there sharp 9. Otherwise, the professional implications follows. So similarly, the new professions have started expecting you to learn all those things which men have been doing. It could be driving, or it could be going to the office, going to the market, or it could be doing all the activities, even in terms of electrical, plumbing, and various other things that you need to do. You started doing it, and everybody is. Now, we have also started moving in terms of, we have gone to different professions. No, but has it reduced all the family responsibility, social responsibility, biological responsibilities? No, it has added. Here is the point that we need to understand. The empowerment is one, in a way, it's good. But at the same time, has it disempowered or at least really empowered men at the same time? That is a question that we need to understand. So there is real empowerment for women to train their kids and their men at home to do the jobs which men have not done, women have been doing. So this is a twist that I'm trying to bring in here. Coming down to this particular modern city responsibilities, the present day scenario is some sort of a different kind of a thing, which gives us some sort of modern city responsibilities, comes with added more risks, more challenges. The moment you're working outside, obviously you need to come late in the office, from the office home. While coming back from office to home, you have different challenges. Either you're taking a cab or maybe auto or walking alone. So those challenges are adding to your personal dimension. So it's only more and more addition. And again, it's basically giving you more challenges in that sense. So when I try to see the perspective of looking it from a different dimension, we need to contextualize women in the modern world. But when this particular aspect of contextualizing women in the modern world, the actual world of empowerment, which was seen in the perspective of past, could be seen in terms of how a lot of psychological complications have added to the expectations and possibilities. So I again go back to this particular concept of actual empowerment, that is the past empowerment, or the recent concept of empowerment which has been given to us in the name of text, which has been given to us in the name of knowledge, which has been given to us in the name of awareness. All those things have added only to the existing knowledge base that people already had. But that becomes some sort of a theoretical dimension. That becomes some sort of a knowledge which is to be understood from an aspect which is not known to everybody, which is, I would put it rather as some sort of incomplete information. I will take one small example that how women are trained in the families and how men are trained in the families. Women basically are told right from the childhood days that the whole world is looking at you and again gazing at you. You need to be cautious, and again, obviously, you need to be extra cautious. So obviously, women are always extra cautious. It is the women who can, without looking at their back or somebody from a distance, they can easily gaze or probably some sort of guess. Who is watching them? Since how long? Which part of their body, with what intention? They can easily understand all these dimensions and again try to see, they can judge almost 99% whether they are having a threat or a bad intention or any ill intentioned person is looking at them. Now this training comes only through socialization, which women have been given right from the childhood days till the death, that you need to keep the whole body as five sensory organs. Keep the whole body as some sort of observable things, not only hearing, not only smelling, not only. So it goes beyond your five senses that you start looking in terms of processing all the data that when you receive, you start making in terms of the judgment is much more beyond your five senses. Now that is very interesting here. That is what our families have given us, some sort of training in the name of socialization, which men have not been trained. When the men have not been trained, obviously they switch off most of these kind of abilities to think and process them at the different level, which is for women. More than women, I would rather now put it on the other side. Now train more women, men, or train your boys in the family that the responsibilities have to be stored. Apart to those issues, so contextually in the modern world, it looks less in terms of psychological expectations. It's not just in terms of sociological expectations. It's not in terms of just biological expectations. It is also now multitasking expectations. Now women are expected to be superwoman, super wife, super moms. Now you need to see in terms of how the Durga or all our female deities had this kind of multiple hands. If only they had multiple legs also, they would probably moving here. Now you need to have multiple legs because you need to travel, take a car, go to office, come back and everything. So you need more wheels rather than legs. So earlier conception was basically have more hands so that you can do multitasking. So multitasking is basically you need to do a lot of work. Defend yourself first and also do cater to the needs of the expectations of your people. It could be your family, it could be your office, it could be your colleagues, it could be your neighbors, it could be your in-laws, it could be n number of expectations coming from all dimensions. So multitasking has been the part of women's role right from the childhood till the deathbed. So nobody has been spared, no woman in the world has been spared from doing this kind of multitasking. She has been trained, but why not this kind of multitasking has been given to men to carry out multitasking aspects? So when I said in the earlier slide that responsibilities in the name of empowerment and again taking up the role of men, we are only, women are only adding more responsibilities and not reducing the responsibilities. Technology might have added one little bit, like washing machine, maybe a gas stove, or maybe micro oven, or maybe some sort of refrigerator. It might have added mixer kind of a thing, but still the basic roles have not changed. So we need to change the roles definitions. That's where the empowerment has to be made in terms of not just the decision of cooking, not just the decision of making in terms of family and family members, family expansion kind of a thing, or financial decisions kind of a thing, but also the roles that has been played at the family level needs to be changed. That we have not understood in different perspective altogether. So the expectation is not only in terms of multitasking, having multiple hands and again do multitasking, doing idli, dosa. Many advertisements have come out with these things that boy, girl, father, husband, in-laws, everybody has different expectations, the same breakfast on the same day. So she is ready to do it. One day it's fine, it looks interesting. The moment you give it as a practice, obviously everybody will start expecting that. Let us prepare every day new dishes for everybody. Why only one in a day? Let there be three dishes for everybody in the family. So people start expecting it. Good. Initially, it looks good. But every day cannot be Sunday. One has to understand, the moment you start giving this kind of understanding that every day you start expecting and again start delivering these kind of things, obviously it becomes a more burden for women rather than. So the sharing aspect is much more missing in this aspect. So this present scenario is basically challenging in the form of contextual empowerment is basically to impress the family members in the family. Women have tried to go all the way beyond her limits. And I think women do understand that she has left or probably sacrificed most of the times breakfast because nothing is left for her. Sometimes lunch is left out, nothing is there. So she has skipped the lunch, sometimes dinner also. Sometimes she has taken the stale food also to satisfy the family members. The sacrifices are there. Not necessarily that only women are sacrificing, men also do sacrifice. I'm not trying to say that it's only women do the great job. Men also do that. But again, what I'm trying to say is the superwoman expectation is basically, the supermom expectation is basically, the expectation of you need to be super is more and more it's adding to the responsibility of women. Now, where is the cutoff point? Now, where is the different challenge here? The challenges are basically you continue to do what is expected. The biological challenges you cannot change. The family roles you cannot change. The motherly challenges you cannot change. Everything is adding. So what is adding is basically to your biological chemical composition changing. The challenges are coming at a different level. We need to understand this particular challenge. So present contextual empowerment is basically in the name of sacrifice, what are you trying to do? Are you trying to only be a sacrificial goat or are you trying to make others also sacrifice? That's a different challenge altogether. So what I'm trying to say here is the contextual challenge is basically not empowerment in terms of decision making, not only going to the self-help groups and various other dimensions, but also to protect yourself from all this kind of unseen, unfore onslaughts happening in the family without or with knowing the knowledge that one has. So leave alone the challenge that you have in terms of physical challenges or the atrocities that happens in the family or the domestic violence that happens in the family. You need to be aware of it. And I think I'm sure you have read sufficiently and Madam also has sufficiently discussed in terms of how domestic violence. So you need to empower on those issues. Those issues I'm not discussing now. So those aspects are again a different dimension altogether. So the present scenario, the moment you get into the childhood and again youth and also you become an adult, automatically your expectations start becoming the new teen. You need to look beautiful. You need to look slim, zero figure, and various other expectations start coming in quite contrary to the biological expectations of your what you need. So there is a greater challenge that what you need to eat and what you should not eat becomes another different dimension. So along with the beauty, you need to have brains. So along with the beauty, you need to have brains and you should also keep yourself healthy. And you should also sleep well and also you should cater to the sacrifices of everybody. So it is adding more responsibility to women in the present context, not reducing anything. The question is basically how to maintain all these things within the 24 hours. Obviously, the pressure is more coming here. We need to understand the challenges of the present women is quite different from the health perspective. Sociological dimensions, I'll be discussing it sufficiently in the coming slides. But then the whole argument is, from the medical perspective, you never had women having heart attacks. Women never had sugar or BP. BP and sugar were only associated at the time of delivery. That period was basically very crucial for every woman because it's not only a life to the newborn baby, but also the life for the woman who delivers the baby. So new life comes with the new packages. So that was completely off. Only that particular period was the only thing. Now, women are facing BP, sugar, and now more and more of heart attacks because of multiple responsibilities coming on to women, which was associated with some sort of affluent family, men, and those who sit and again do nothing but keep on eating. It was diseases of the kings or diseases of some sort of people who have only done nothing but eating. But now women have started facing it now. The whole issue now is, why are these new challenges coming into the picture, which was absent to women? women already had the advantage of cleaning their blood every month. So new blood was coming every day. So women were much more stronger. Their body, RBCs, WBCs were much more reproduced every month, which was never done with men. But now how the whole scenario is coming is the pressure is more, and again, the whole body composition, various other things is completely adding. Now, my argument is, why are we trying to equate in the name of empowerment? Empowerment need not be always in terms of trying to see how men are able to lift the heavy equipments. Now you have JCBs and various other things where men can be easily sidelined, and again, you have few equipments to lift all heavy things have come. So men can be easily sidelined. It's not the power, physical power that matters. Now it isn't different responsibilities that matter. So as a result, what is happening is when people try to copy or emulate or probably try and understand the activities of people in cities, the same responsibilities are passing on to rural areas. The responsibilities of rural women have definitely not come down, but it is only adding. As I said, the technology has not gone to that extent of to the rural area, but again, the responsibilities definitely have gone to the rural area. So men are more relaxing, or women are more doing more work. So the responsibility and again activities needs to be understood from a different angle here. It is adding more stress rather than giving leverage, giving more relaxation period. So this timetable or maybe structure of every society having its own understanding has altered women rather than men. Men are in a better place. Women are in a differently place. Now that needs to be understood. Why I'm saying it is actual, contextual. Now the context is totally different, that everybody has to do a lot of work. So people are smart, whether in family or in office, anybody trying to shift the responsibility into somebody so that you are safe. I am safe. I need to be safe. Or let me push on the responsibility. Same thing happens in the family. Slowly, all the responsibility. You cook, prepare the tea. You do the new dishes. You do everything. I will come and relax. I'll do lots of work at home, computer, and various other things. So all the responsibility of taking care of women, girls, boys, children, various other things falls on the women in that sense. So the issues which were supposed to be coming at a later stage has started coming into women's in a much more early stage now. Today's construct is basically theoretical understanding is basically to understand how colleges have started working. I'll come to in terms of the virtual part a little later today after discussing a couple of other issues now. What are we trying to understand in the name of contextual empowerment? I'll come to those issues now by discussing these issues. That the new challenges in the context are basically going beyond boundaries. What kind of boundaries are we talking about? It could be self, or it could be family, or it could be professional or societal expectations. And then it goes on adding, and again, it becomes much more self-perpetuating. It becomes more self-challenging in that sense. So multitasking and multiple roles have become much more stringent. And again, it also has added more challenges to women. But at the same time, we are trying to understand that women need to be defendant as a social taboo and various other things. Whatever happens, it happens to men. I'll come to this particular slide little now, so that because precaution and again prevention is better than cure. There is some sort of an understanding. The action will not affect me is the confidence that what most of the men are, the people who are doing kind of wrong actions, are basically addressing this. Every action and reaction will have some sort of an effect. But in most of the cases between the women and men, and any social practice or social bad practices or ill practices that's happening, it is definitely having, because it is affecting only women, not men. That is what is the confidence that's coming. Law will take its own course, and again, everything happens. No immediate responsibility is coming onto men. It is all the women go through is a social taboo. biological challenges that they go through and the responsibilities that they go through, they have to face, and also the implications that they have to go through is basically affecting them. So none affect them. Who? Men are not affected because of this issue. Say way that nothing happens to me even if I do this kind of any action in the name of defense or in the name of offense or in the name of all those actions that needs to be done. So men are not affected. So that needs to change, that nothing will affect me is the confidence that some bad elements are perpetuating. Even if the police wants to catch you, the law will give a different course. And again, when the law has its own different course, obviously the judgment takes a different course, and various other things has its own time. And again, obviously it is having its own implication. The suffering has been more on the women's side. So when the suffering is on the more on the women's side, obviously we need to change the whole scenario upside down, or maybe turn the whole table around by saying that one is a precaution and again the prevention in the present scenario in a different way. I'm not trying to say that you need to be more conscious and again also more cautious and again you need not to come out of the woods. No, I would rather put it, don't put yourself in the defensive position, put yourself in the offensive position. Learn all the skills that is required, learn all the things that is required, and again have all the weapons that you need to have to counter yourself and again to safeguard yourself. It could be law, when I'm saying the weapon, it could be law, it could be awareness, or it could be in terms of the knowledge that you need to have, or it could be in terms of the arguments, or it could be in terms of your articulation, whatever it may be, in the verbal. In the real world, in terms of your defense, obviously you need to have all those kind of gadgets which needs to be required. But more than that, these things have already been told by many people. How to defend yourself. I'm not trying to say in terms of go and defend, I can rather put it in go and offend. The moment you start giving this kind of a message to the society that you are offending and you don't go and stop for the defense, obviously the society looks at you a different level. We don't experiment this at the family level, but again, it needs to be understood from a different angle. But the real world needs to be faced and you need to be equipped. The equipment is much more required here. Now, what kind of equipment are we talking about? It is basically the knowledge that we have in the name of empowerment is basically nothing but a theoretical knowledge which needs to go beyond bookish, which needs to go beyond text, which needs to go beyond aspects of images. I'll come to these issues. Virtual empowerment is basically, I'm trying to see in terms of the digital world and the real world in different level altogether. How we do it, what do we do it, are different issues. But more than actual is the real form. Now, what do we mean by more than actual? What is shown to us, what is explained to us, or what is given in the form of dimensions, or in the form of text, or in the form of some sort of empowerment tech lectures, or empowerment textbooks, empowerment related notebooks, empowerment related, all those kind of awareness are on the one side. But the reality is, how do you face the real situation? The reality is basically, how do you counter the real world? The reality is basically, how do we make the real challenges address in that direction? It looks nice in the virtual world, basically new forms of expectations, superwoman, multitasking, beautiful, fulfilling all aspects, all those things are fine. Coming to the real world now, it is a virtual world, is basically, it is the digital world. The future world is basically, all of us are hooked onto your mobile instruments. All our mobiles basically are asking us to understand how the mobile has everything. It looks nice. It looks nice. We have the smartphones and we have all those kind of gadgets, which is completely integrated into a small unit. Are we really aware of this kind of challenges? The virtual world is, the moment you are into any operating system, whether it is iPhone or Android or Windows, doesn't matter whichever operating system you're using, all those operating system ask all the permissions for your input devices. Now, which are those input devices? It is asking your permission to accept and give permission to your mic first. Your mic is taken away. That means your mic is on 24 hours bar 7. Look at all the apps when you are looking into the moment you download any app, all the apps will ask first your permission to your mic. Second is to your camera. Third one is to your images, to your hard disk or external storage devices, all the storage devices. That means you are giving permission to the, you're opening the doors of your house that you can come and take away whatever you want, whenever you want. Your mobile phone is nothing but your private life, which is no more private now. With all the apps, everything is you have given permission. That means your mic is on 24/7. Whatever private conversation you have with your family members or private life or the social life, doesn't matter. Everything is recorded by those apps. So your private life is gone. So women need to understand that your private life is no more private life. It has become a public life the moment you have your smartphone with you. Never carry your private mobile phone. I would still put it as a private mobile phone, which is to the other members, it is still a private because nobody can access your mobile. That's what we are under the assumption, because it has a password, it has a pattern, it has sequence, it has my finger thumb. No, all those things are nonsense because you have given permission to the app owners that everything can be stored. The moment you take away your, please don't carry your mobile phone to your bedroom or to your bathrooms, wherever you are changing your dresses, because the camera is always on. Please keep it in mind. Nobody has told you the camera is always on. You never know which app is capturing what kind of images. Which app is capturing what conversations, audio files. Every conversation is recorded. Do you think the WikiLeaks has come out just like that after something is leaking from the America or various other global kind of a thing? Everything is leaked. So you are no more a private mobile phone, is no more private, it is a public phone. It is only with you, so that mic can capture only your voice, so that the camera can capture your images. Please be aware that nothing is private in your sense. Nothing is private. The moment you have given permission to your storage devices, your external devices, whatever it might be, all your pictures and videos that you have captured, either it is available on the drive, cloud, or it is still continued to be accessed by the people, whoever wants to access it. So there is no private life, there is no private space, there is no private dimension. So the most thing is very important that don't capture your good photos also and post it onto any of your social apps, whether it's WhatsApp, Google account, Twitter, name the social app, don't post your photographs, because the photographs can be morphed and again it can be misused at different levels. So there's a lot of misuse being happening in the name of digital world. Only thing you need to know how to work on it, and again obviously anything can be done. Initially it looks like everything is so nice, but the digital world is so rigid that anything can happen, and when it hits you, it's like corona, when it comes and hits you, you never know. Any virus, anybody, anything can hum and happen to you. You may be thinking that, no, I am safe. You are not safe. My children are safe. No, your children are not safe. I am old in terms of age. No, still you are not safe. Your mobile phone has all the bank details. Your mobile phone has all the personal details. You have given yes to everything. You have recorded everything there. You have detailed information of your PAN, Aadhaar card, name your personal identity, everything is available on your phone. When it is available on your phone, obviously it is available for the public, all the app users. Suddenly app goes off and the data is available. Now, why do you think the phone calls comes to you from the bank or insurance company or some other company, suddenly you start getting the calls? You have never given the phone calls to anybody, or you have never given the phone numbers to anybody, but still they know your name. They still, they call you and they still have your IT details. They still know that what is your ability or capability of your bank credentials. How do they know? So please be aware of all this digital world. It's not the men has to be aware, women has to be aware, because many men, when they have working or non-working women, doesn't matter, they keep all their accounts with the wife, so that they think that women account has never been accessed by others. Only I am having access. The moment it is there in the smartphone, everything is accessible to everybody. whether working or non-working woman, child or girl, doesn't matter. Images on the other side, identity is another side, your personal data is another side, your bank details on the other side, your identity is another side, your status is another side. You name it and everything, the history, everything is completely taken away by people. This is the virtual world. This is a digital world. You need to be empowered on these lines. Technology has, in a way, given us some sort of an advantage. On the side, it has also given us lots of disadvantages, because 24 hours you're carrying your mic and the speaker is somewhere else, camera here and the screen is somewhere else, data is yours, but somebody else is watching your bank accounts, photo is yours, somebody else is watching with some other bad intentions. Imagine the culprits, the bad intentions, violent people kind of a thing that's happening. Be aware. Now, that is what is the most need of the hour is basically, you need to empower yourself, not only, you know, be cautious in terms of, don't go on having aspects which are unnecessary here. So we need to understand that the virtual world is totally different. The real world is totally different. There's something wrong going on with somebody. Is it clear now? Okay. Suddenly these things are connected to those things, some other issue is getting popped up. If it is audible and visible, I'll just continue. Otherwise, I request Hemant to make me a call or Rakraju to make me a call. Now, coming to this particular digital world, basically, which is now I'm trying to give a different image altogether, which is looking like it's frightening. But the whole idea is, in terms of the whole digital world, is not only looking into your identity, but not only looking into your images and looks and various other things, it's also looking into your history. What is important is your background. What is important is trying to locate you. Your location is traced. Your status is traced. Your imaginations, your moods, your behaviors, everything is traced and everything is going haywire. Are we not supposed to be aware of all these issues? Are we not supposed to go through these dimensions? Understand these perspectives. The challenges that women now in the present world need to understand is basically not to have a mobile phone, but how to use a mobile phone. Not just to have a smartphone, but how to use a smartphone. There is a technical awareness that one need to understand, that why do we need to always keep the location enabled or disabled. When you are sharing this location with your family members, it's fine, but otherwise everybody is knowing who is doing what. Your status, why do we need to unnecessarily give your status to the whole large public world, which is unnecessarily and again which is unwarranted? Whether you're single or want to have a relationship are different. Where you go, keeping a snap of that and again posting it on the social media gives the imagination and also gives the real-time information to the bad character people to do all those things which you would not have expected. So that's the real challenge that's coming in. It's not the sheer challenge in terms of multitasking of Durgas having multiple hands, but now you need to place your smartphones in the real world, your laptops in the real world. Do not store anything on your mobile phone. The first thing that I would tell you, do not store anything on your mobile phone. Do not store anything on your email account, because your email account is not yours. Tomorrow, as an email provider, I may say that my privacy policy has changed. I will take away every data of yours. It could be a personal data. It could be any data. And tomorrow I'll say that I'll start charging for 1 MB. I'll charge you $100. And obviously you'll say that, no, let that whole data go. You might be thinking that is there in the cloud, or it may be in the drive or some other space which cannot be accessed. Everything is accessed. Large databases are either Google or Amazon, whatever it may be, all are doing metadata analysis of our behavior for which is much more required for the artificial intelligence analysis and other things. Whose data is being used? Obviously, your Facebook data is being used. Obviously, your all social media data is being used. None of us are aware of it. Why do you think that the moment you start looking for a book, the advertisements from different publishers come in? Why do you think that you want to buy an iron instrument, then suddenly all the advertising of that particular start coming in? It's basically artificial intelligence, where again your tastes, your behaviors, your moods, your requirements are being traced by artificial intelligence. Huge servers, unimaginable amount of data is being analyzed in a very micro level, for a fraction of a second, then immediately you are being addressed. So you are customized to your needs, requirements, basically your expectations, everything is being done. So everything is documented, everything is recorded. Your history, your background, your behavior, your moods, your location, your status, your relationships, your networks, your connections, your family members, your family tree, your friendship tree, everything is traced. You remember this Kanakadasa? This guru tells, goes and again try and eat the banana fruit where the God is not available. Except all the disciples, Kanakadasa comes and again comes back and tells that, no, God is everywhere. No, God is not everywhere. That you have no safety in the real sense. The mind is not peace, the virtual world is not peace. Even if you have put all the data anywhere in different forms, kindly start deleting it. Do not store in the virtual world any data. Any of your personal data, anywhere in the virtual world, don't store it. Even in the computer which has an internet access, please don't store it in all these things. Because anybody can access your any device the moment it is connected to internet. So this is a real challenge one has to understand. Women have to be told that these are the challenges in the real world, which is posing a different challenge altogether, and you need to empower yourself. It's not just a theoretical knowledge. It's not just a textbook knowledge. It's not the image that I'm talking. It is, again, the real world that is challenging at a different level. So when it comes to the challenge which needs to be understood from the perspective of defense and offense now. Do you need to equip yourself with the kind of weapons that you're talking about? The sprays and various other things to defend now? Now, what kind of a spray will be helpful in the digital world? If your image is morphed and again the digital photographs is morphed and other things, you're totally unaware of, uncaught, and again you will be in the wrong place. Now, the whole, again, different challenges would come into the different level here is I'll go to the next slide. Digital world, basically, challenges are the identity. You may be thinking that your identity is lost. The person who is taking all your identity is having anonymity. You may have friends on the Facebook and social media and various other things. You never know what kind of image that they are posing. You know, you do not know, the anonymity still remains. You may be thinking that I have posted a different thing. Nobody can identify me. Everybody can identify you. You may have a wrong identity, but still people can identify you. You may be thinking that you're invincible. Nobody is invincible. Everything can be traced. The whole computer data is taken care of in terms of how your behavior changes. People have already started using your data to understand in terms of how you are changing. Challenges are being in terms of you are likely to be trapped. Now, it could be in terms of luring, or it could be in terms of blackmailing. It could be in terms of taking away your private space. When I said in terms of private space, your bedroom is not your private space, your kitchen is not your private space, your bathroom is not your private space, nothing is private space. All your pictures, conversation, everything is gone. So you may be thinking that you're unapproachable or you're untraceable. Everything is traceable. Everything is possible. Because you don't know the security that is being required, and none of us have the ability to understand what kind of security levels we need to do. Because you have given permission to all the apps in every sense. The real, actual, the past, contextual is the present scenario and the future in the digital world. When I said the virtual empowerment is basically women need to empower themselves in these kind of scenario, not by understanding the words only in the form of textbooks or the theories that comes from a contextual manner. Unfortunately, we don't understand, and most of us have faced these challenges, but we have not shared these challenges. We have understood it, but we have not shared it. We have faced it, but we have not processed it. If only we start sharing these kind of things, there can be a better platform to express, a better platform to share, a better platform to come out with a new digital world, which would be much more women friendly in that sense. So I moved from the past, that is historically how women have been constructed in terms of biological construction, sociological constructions, psychological expectations and other things, how historically women have been confined to or probably defined in terms of roles and various other things. Contextually, when I said that the present scenario becomes much more important to understand how the present scenario gives a different challenge altogether. So the later part where I've discussed you basically with much more challenging is the virtual world. So you need not come out with any theoretical framework or maybe using some sort of blacksmith or any time world door. No, external people from other world have to tell you what kind of theoretical concept needs to be told. I have not used any of the concepts, any of the theories being promulgated by the feminists or theoreticians or the Western social constructions or maybe theoretical dimensions. I only shared the issues which are much more real in addressing these issues. You can name them. I would rather leave it to the women folk to come out with new concepts, new theories, new frameworks, new apps, new equipments that are required in terms of coming out with a new mobile instrument, which are much more women friendly. Has there been some sort of, except adding some sort of covers for women, instruments are not women friendly. Start questioning these things. Two-wheelers are not women friendly. The cars are not women friendly. Of course, now the self-driven are probably clutchless or gearless kind of thing has come. Now auto driver kind of thing. There are some sort of things. But now women should start thinking into the real world, the virtual world, how the new challenges are to be faced from a different dimension altogether. With these words, I would definitely ask women to think in terms of precaution and prevention is better than cure is a different level. But train your boys, your men at home to think on every aspect from a different altogether. Socialization process has to change. Work sharing has to change. The responsibilities have to change. Understanding of women has to change. This happens only a boy becomes a man, and man after marrying only understands the woman. And after a time when he will have a girl child, understands the whole process of childhood to a mother or old age process. Now change all those things at the childhood day itself. Change men, change boys, not just women in the name of socialization. With these words, I'll stop here. Thank you very much. Thank you, organizers. I'll stop here.
Thank you for your valuable presentation. It was very informative to the audience, sir. Now I request delegates to clarify your doubts or questions, if any, with the resource person, please.
Please, please.
Dear participants, it is open for discussion, so you can ask any question to the resource person.